This is Justin from Weaponizer. You're watching Savage Bootlegs. Are all about weapons, and the band's art is pretty much just weapons piled on top of weapons piled on top of weapons. If you were in a Dungeons and Dragons battle against the clan of canine druids known as Speed Wolf, what weapons would you use and why?
Speed Wolf, huh? Probably use some coors to distract them.
Yeah. Thank you.
We're Weaponizer from Denver.
Anybody got any roll aids? We got a new one for you.
Can you tell us about the equipment you use on tour with Weaponizer?
Bunch of garbage, really. Right now I'm using this Jet City amp. That's it's a Soldano SLO 100 copy, and I did some modifications to that. That's the only amp that hasn't broken down lately, so that's what I've been using. I've actually been using that in my other band. I use it for guitar and Weaponizer, but I also use it bass for my other band. It's kind of my go-to amp for everything. Trying to think, the other guy who plays guitar with us is using some PV solid state thing. I don't know what it is, but usually we just use whatever's loud and works, you know.
We'll be right back.
Shout out to Mudland Forest for holding down the mic stands and shit.
You booked the Weaponizer tour completely DIY with no agency help, but you also play bass with Necrofilth, who's on tour now with Ghoul and Phobia. What are the differences between this and the more grassroots DIY tours, and what advice do you have for new bands that are booking their own tours?
I guess as far as advice, I think it's best to, because I have a lot of venue contacts, you know, and I know some promoters, shit like that, but I think it's always best to find like a band that you really like in a town, same style, try to get in with them, because they're the ones who are going to tell people, you know, like about, you know, to come out, get people to come out, and, you know, they'll be one to hang out with. A lot of times if you work with a venue, or certain promoters, at least from my experience, you could just end up, you know, playing to fucking nobody.
Yeah.
You know, or having a bad time, or showing up and the show's canceled or something.
Right.
So what I like to do now is I just try to find like my favorite band in that city or two and hit them up, see if they can help out, if they want to get a hold of a promoter they like. You know, because things change so much in cities, you know, especially these days, you know, places are going out of business and people are, you know, quitting promoting, and, you know, you never know like how it's going to be when you go back. But this tour has been great. Like, we just get, you know, kind of treated better than we should. You know, we get food and fucking beer, and we get paid more than we, you know, cost us to get, you know, like with gas and stuff.
Right.
It's just fucking awesome.
All right, we got another new one for you. Not that you know the difference.
This is Vulture.
What's the craziest thing you remember happening on that Weaponizer tour?
This thing happened. I'm trying to think of something I can talk about.
This isn't going to be censored, so you have options.
Yeah. I think I was just going to say, shit. I'm going to go with a no comment on that one.
Okay.
This is gangrene.
We'll be right back.
Brandon for making this shit happen. He's a fucking cool dude. He does a lot of fucking work around here.
Where can people go to buy merch or listen to more Weaponizer online or whatever?
I guess as cheesy as it is, Facebook, you know, because we got our links there. We have some stuff on Bandcamp if it's available, you know. Like, we just have a link to order it there. Cool. So, you know, if people go to the Facebook page, I think there's some links on there. You can get right to it.
Shit, shock out of it.
Sucking the juice from a rotten commie potato.
We see water. Yeah.